convenience yield. Now, before going into convenience yield, let us start with this fair price of the futures contract. Now, what is the fair price of futures contract? It is the spot price plus cost of carry minus inflows. Now, when we say inflows, it is the income from that particular asset. Now, these inflows may also be intangibles. Intangibles means it cannot be measured in monetary terms. So, intangible flows are values perceived by the market participants just by holding that asset. Now, let us consider an example here. In case of famines, in case of extreme weather conditions, people tend to buy more vegetables than they actually need and they stock it up in their refrigerator. Suppose they might have bought onions at say 50 rupees per kg. So after buying and stocking it, the price of onions may go up to even 100 rupees. Just because it has gone up to 100 rupees, people will not go out in the market and sell their own stock and make a profit on it. No, they are not going to do it. They just hold on to it for their own consumption. That is an example of convenience yield. The satisfaction that they get, the convenience that they get out of just holding that asset is called as the convenience yield. So, convenience yield is nothing but the intangible inflow.